today we wrote history.
3.9 million inhabitants and we're in the final of the World Cup.
Luka Modric.
There were 14 players out of 23 in our World Cup squad used to play for Dinamo.
22.5 million euro. Any Levy and Zoran Mamić, sport director.
Došli smo u školu, počeli raditi, nije bilo puno. Jedno desetak ih je došlo na nastavu I krenule su granate, bum, bum, bum. Kad je prva profi ukala onako malo bliže, svi su ono klekli ispod klupa.
O to ne htio pričati da čovjeku skinja balon nogom s glave, što je ono nemoguće. Nisam vjerovao da on to može napraviti, kao Bruce Lee.
So this is the second hotel that the Modric family lived in.
This is the hotel where he spent last 2 years of his of him as a refugee.
I don't speak Croatian, but I can make out the name Beckham.
He's not a sheep, but Beckham from Obrovac. Obrovac is his birthplace. So.
The Obrovac Beckham.
This hotel has been abandoned for several years now, as you can see.
It doesn't
and
look
this
good.
Is the place where the biggest anti-Modric graffiti took place when the Mamić story broke out. You can't read Luka Modric anywhere here because it has been deleted or covered over.
So it's not a widespread opinion that people dislike Modric.
You will remember this day, and that refers to the day he went on court to testify in Mamić's case.
When they say he committed perjury.
That's right.
Zdravko Mamić is a former executive president of Dinamo Zagreb. In 2015, he was arrested on suspicion of tax evasion and bribery. He was sentenced in the summer of 2018 to 6.5 years in prison for fraud relating to the transfer of players, including Dejan Lovren and Luka Modric.
Specifičan posao je, opet se veže za Tottenham. Neće niko odgovoriti, ja ću, aha. You go up and down, please. Please, you. Ne ako vrati, nego da dadi od profita kojeg će on zaraditi.
U nekom periodu ili cijelu karijeru?
U cijelu karijeru.
During the trial, Modric was called as a witness. Modric signed multiple contracts with Mamić during his Dinamo career. Upon moving to Tottenham, Modric guaranteed part of his transfer fee to Mamić, who had helped him financially in his early professional years. In 2017, Modric stated that he signed the annex in his contract, which pledged the fee to Mamić 10 years earlier. But in court, he said it was signed in 2004, when he got his first contract at Dinamo. Luka Modric was charged with perjury and was cleared in October of this year. But the episode severely hit Modric's reputation with certain sections of Croatian society, where Mamić is a deeply polarizing figure.
I kad je on, znači, otišao 2004. godine, on je tražio od mene da raskinemo taj ugovor I ja sam na to pristao, jer sam ga jako volio. U tom transferu gdje je on otišao van je moj sin dosta zaradio. Ili mi kao obitelj, kako god hoćete.
Prvi predsjednik Hrvatske, first president Croatia.
Mamić fled Croatia the night before his sentence was passed. He is currently situated over the border in Bosnia-Herzegovina, where he holds dual citizenship. During the perjury case, Modric and Mamić were prevented from having any contact with one another.
Znači, Dinamo je od engleskog kluba dobio sve, ali su Dinamo I klub imali ne samo za Luku Modrića, nego za stotine igrača. Prije su imali dogovor o podjeli transfera. Neko je imao 50-50, neko 60-40, neko 40-60.
Nije ta praksa bilo neko... ukinuo da je već u to doba.
Ne, tu praksu sam ja ukinuo.
Tu
praksu sam upravo ja ukinuo. Ovo su bili nekoliko slučajeva gdje to nismo mogli napraviti, jer klub tada nije mogao plaćati igrače kao što plaća danas 500.000 eura, 700.000 eura ili Sudanija 2,5 miliona eura, nego je Luka Modrić potpisao ugovor za 1000 eura na 10 godina. Prema tome, Luka je trebao igrati do 2014. godine u Dinamu za 1000 eura po slovu ugovora. Ali je tada Luka dogovorio da će mu Dinamo, s obzirom da mu ne plaća te velike plaće, da će mu dati dio transfera. I dogovorili su se pola-pola. A temeljem ugovora koji je Luka imao privatno sa mojim sinom, odnosno s njegovom agencijom, su Luka i agencija podijelili Lukin dio novca.
It was the heaviest criticism Modric had ever faced in his homeland. As well as the graffiti popping up outside his former residence, Modric was confronted with calls for him to be stripped of the captaincy of the national team.
Kažem, uopće nije ništa priča. Njega to kaže, njegov pokazatelj, ja sam vam rekao, kad je, na primjer, ga napalo to, za to suđenje, on, njegov pokazatelj je to što je napravio reprezentaciju. Znači, to je njegov inat, to je njegov inat i garantiram da on sa tim svojim inatom napravio ovo što je napravio. Jer on da nije poveo takvu ekipu, teško bi mi to osvojili. Kažem, to je njegov inat i to u njemu. To je u njemu, kada bio sam s njegovim tatom i kažem da mu nije bilo lako u tim trenucima kada ga napalo, napadalo sa svih strana narod hrvatski, a dečko ništa nije kriv, tako da on je samo jedan veliki sportaš i jedan veliki gospodin.
Slučajno ili ne slučajno moj sin. Prema tome niko od toga ne bježi, ali u toj priči smo mi napravili smo igrača i napravili korist Dinamu, hrvatskom nogometu, Modriću, pa u konačnici i mom sinu. Luka je najbolja osoba na svijetu. Najvažniji za svoj uspjeh. Svi drugi, uključujući i mene, su tu marginalni. Netko je pomogao više ili manje. On je sve stvorio sam. On je igrao, on se odrica, on se borio, on je živio za nogomet.
Pa iskreno, sad malo... Ja ću vam reći stvar, moj otac kad je bio tu, on je rekao da taj mali može biti Maradona. Sad je to malo čudno što ja to tako govorim, on tako, kad ga je gleda, on kaže ako nastavi raditi, da taj mali stvarno može napraviti vrhunsku karijeru. Mo uvijek smo igrali su ispred hotel Kolovara, hotel Iž, uvijek se nogome kaže, no uvijek, mi, znači kod nas nije bilo ni mobitela, ni ništa, kod nas je samo bilo lopta.
The Croatian War of Independence lasted from 1991 until 1995. It left thousands dead, and many more, including the Modrics, had to flee their homes as refugees. The Modrics settled in the coastal town of Zadar, where hotels were converted into refugee shelters. It was here that Luka first began to play football, in the car park, at school, and with the Zadar youth teams.
In this very car park, they tell us that this is the first area where Luka played with a football as well. This is where he learned it.
That's how the story goes, because he only played football. That's the only thing in his mind.
Inače, ja živim, moja kuća odmah do hotela Kolovara i ja sam njega često viđala sa prozora moje kuhinje, on je dole na travnjaku lupalo, po cijelo popodne. I onda bi ja njemu rekla, ajde Luka, dosta više, ajde pisat domaći rad. A on bi rekao, evo još samo zera.
I znate da idete u školu koju je išao tko?
Luka Modrić.
Ja prva, dakle Luka je... Cijela ta njegova generacija krenuli su u školu 92. 93. godine i te tri školske prve godine su uglavnom sjećanja mračna ili ratna, ali u svemu tome i to veselje i ta djeca su te nekako održavala.
So this is the monument for all Dinamo Zagreb fans that died during the Croatian War for Independence. Many of them did. And the sign says that that war began on the May 13th, 1990, when the Dinamo Red Star game was never played, that was never finished with the big fan riots and
which was the Boban kick.
That's right, when Boban kicked the policeman.
The war lasted from 1991 to 1995, and this was the period when Croatian National League started, and our team started under this hybrid name, Hajanski, but no one in those days, nobody thought about football, you know.
To je dijete koje oni i njegovi prijatelji tadašnjima ih par, mislim da ostao s njima i dalje dobar iz tog hotela. Oni su redovito dolazili u školu, dakle bez obzira na to vrijeme odrađivala se nastava, nekad je bilo sat, dva, tri, nekad su nas granate potjerale doma, nekad bi škola bila zatvorena par dana, ali se uglavnom radilo. Učilo se i radilo se sve što je, eto se ono doba trebalo naučiti čitanje, pisanje, vježbanje. Čak smo kad su stale malo granate 93. četvrte godine, bilo je redovito igranje vani, nismo baš imali često dvoranu, ali je vani igralište bilo slobodno. Eto, i to je vjerojatno bio prvi doticaj sa loptom.
Jeste znali da je išao u ovu školu prije?
Meni je učiteljica rekla. Pokazala sliku i onda donijela na majicu od potpisa i sam tek sam sad saznala da je Luka išao u ovu školu.
A sad si saznala?
Da.
Si ga prepoznala slicu?
Ne, isprve ne. Onda poslije kad mi učiteljica pokazala na adresu.
Ali ono što je imao Luka, to nikad u životu vidio nisam. To je zbilja nešto čudno, a pogotovo je interesantno što tako jedan mali momak koji ne izgleda tako moćan, osjetiš svu njegovu moć kad ima loptu u nogama. Jer tad je on pravi. I ne mogu ga ni gurnuti, ni faulirati. On bi sve to preskočio, prošao. Čak je radio na betonu klizeće startove, nikad nisam ja da se ozlijede, da ima ikakvu ranicu. Sve je bio gumiran, da. Vrlo, vrlo gumiran.
Despite his tiny frame, Luka was gaining notice. His form for the Zadar youth sections first brought attention from Hajduk Split, but they opted against taking him on because they had reservations over his size. It left Luka heartbroken. However, a call from a local coach alerted Mamić and Dinamo to his talents.
Luka je tada bio, znači on je bio član moje agencije koju sam ja, kad sam ja prešao u Dinamo, je preuzeo moj sin, a Luka je bio u Dinamo, igrač Dinamo. Prvo sam imao informacije da se radi o jednoj dosta teškoj obiteljskoj situaciji. To je u stvari bio jedan od glavnih razloga uz Tomu Bašića zbog kojeg sam ja Luku prigrlio. Jer vidite, dijete sa 14 godina, Luka je bio krhke građe i stvarno ne možete pretpostaviti da će biti uopće ozbiljan igrač, a kamoli ovo što je postigao.
Živio je ovdje, tako je. Njih četvorica su živjela ovdje nekih godinu dana, nakon toga su otišli u stan.
Kako si, Lator? Dobar dan.
Tako je, naravno, mi kad nam je bilo dosadno ili možda iz nekog izlaska, kad nismo išli kući, onda smo se vratili kod njih, prespavali kod njih, igrali igrice, sve što mladi rade.
I bilo je blizu do treninga onda?
Je, da, i onda kako je blizu, naravno zakasnimo, jer nam je jako blizu.
Tako. A ovaj je, recimo, neću reći koji.
It's like successful player and unsuccessful player.
Kad je došao nije, nakon godinu dana, da. Znači, godinu dana, šest mjeseci mu je trebalo da pokaže sve. Nakon toga je išao i u reprezentaciju. I nakon toga, jednostavno, uz taj karakter i talenat, nije se moglo desiti da on odigra, recimo, dvije utakmice za redom loše. Jer jednostavno, ako krene loše utakmicu, njegov karakter ga je tjerao da na kraju bude jedan od boljih na toj istoj utakmici, naravno.
Modric, Mamić says, had a development plan laid out for him at Dinamo. He needed games, so he was sent on loan to Zrinjski in the Bosnian-Herzegovinian League. It was regarded in those days as one of the most physically demanding places for a footballer to make his living.
Onda je otišao u Zrinjski u jednu ligu, ja bih rekao, kolokvijalno rečeno mesarsku ligu, gdje je svaki duel između igrača, ko prođe, pričat će se. Ko preživi, pričat će se.
Modric aced it, earning the league's Player of the Year award.
Imao je ovdje dosta grčeva. Jer je davao 200% na utakmici i svaka utakmica pred kraja je bilo upitnik zbog njegovih grčeva. Niko nije cijeli stade, nije htio da on izađe. On jednom padne, pa se ustane, pa drugi put padne i onda je morao izaći. Znali su ga iznositi od grčeva. Jer je za nas kao djecu tada bila to jaka liga.
So this is like the graffiti about Luka Modric in Mostar. This was made like 6-7 years ago. So not while he was playing in Zrinjski, but not now when he is best player of the world. So that just shows how fans in Mostar adore him. He played here for one season. He was voted best player of the league, despite the fact that Zrinski was like bottom of the table, middle bottom. When Zrinski played as a visiting team, the home fans would like, of course, support their team, but also applaud Luka Modric, whether he was substituted or just made some great move, some dribble, something. Really, fans here could recognize, wow, this is not a player who should play in Bosnian league.
After Zrinski, Modric would be loaned again. There was no space at Dinamo owing to the presence of Niko Kranjčar, and so he was given to Inter Zaprešić, a team on the outskirts of Zagreb. They were flying in the first half of the season and in contention for the title, but Dinamo recalled Modric. They now had the space in their team because Kranjčar was controversially sold to Hajduk.
To vreme su bili dresovi, oni veliki, široki i tak dalje. Oko njega je stalno sve lepršalo. Jednostavno, small za njega je bilo XL. Kad su odlazili oni čale iz Intera natrag u zimskom prelaznom roku, nisam im platio zadnju plaću od 5000 kuna i tako da sam im ostal dužan. Znači,
i dan danas.
Povijesna je činjenica da još uvijek, ne znam koliko je sa to sa kamatama, ali mi smo ostali dužni Luki Modriću 5000 kuna.
Modric would firmly establish himself in the Dinamo lineup over the next three seasons, earning three league titles and two doubles, becoming Croatia's outstanding young talent, with all of Europe's big clubs competing for his signature.
This is his first title in Croatia, this one, 2006. And we can say he launched the winning streak after he won the championship in 2006. Our team won 11 consecutive titles. So he participated in the first three.
Mm-hmm. He won two doubles and three?
Two doubles, but not in 2006. His second and third championship title were the double.
Kako zamišljate vaš prvi, kako biste voljeli da izgleda vaš prvi susret kad završi cijeli ovaj spor?
Sigurno će to biti susret, bar sa moje strane, oca i sina. Znači, ja sam se odrekao ovdje svih potraživanja u odnosu na njega za vrijeme čitave njegove karijere i još je on otkazao mom sinu zastupanje. Ali ga ljubim svim bićem.
Luka Modric was Croatia's heartbeat at the World Cup. He was given FIFA's golden ball as the outstanding player in the tournament, and in the autumn also earned FIFA and UEFA's individual honours for 2018. To his trophy collection, he added yet another Champions League title, his fourth in five seasons since joining Real Madrid. Not bad for a boy from such humble origins.
So in this beautiful Velebit land, landscape, Luka Modric grew up.
So this is, because I've read before that he grew up in his grandfather's house, but this is actually the family house.
This was the family house, right?
Yeah. There's no place to play football here. I mean, we are probably 800 to 1,000 meters high, maybe even more.
And you can imagine the road was not like this 20 years ago.
No, the road was probably like that 20 years
ago.
Yeah,
more of that.
And if a ball starts rolling,
it ends up somewhere in the sea.
It rolls to the lake or to the sea down there. The house stands abandoned. I mean, it's not what we'd expect to see from, you know, a childhood home and for somebody who's so revered in a country. Why does it look like this?
Because no one has really touched it for 20 years. And more than 20 years.
And they left the house. They had to leave the house quickly.
Yeah, they had to leave the house. His grandfather was killed just outside the house. By Serbian military troops or whoever, and they had to leave.
During the war, this was occupied land.
Yeah, this was occupied territory. Yeah, yeah. Zadar was defended, but this was occupied.
Well, I just want to walk around to the side of the house here, because just at the back of the Modric family property, we see a sign
no
written
trespass.
Up there. A sign up there written in Croatian, and the big writing says "No trespass." But tell us, what else does it say on that sign?
Well, it says no trespass because there's a high danger of mine, landmines.
And that's common. We've seen some of those signs on the drive up here as well.
Yeah, because since this was the occupied territory, so the enemies left the landmines buried somewhere, and it's not safe to walk here.
There's one tiny little clue that this is the home of the childhood home of Modric.
And that's something that fans did.
The Croatia flag, which I presume is put up in the summer during the World Cup, maybe.
Yeah, the biggest one is "Hail Captain Luka," and this one says "Cheers Luka." This one says "Thank you Luka, our captain." It's a mark that it's a special house.
I think it deserves more of a mark, but that's what's here so far. Yeah. It almost feels religious here. You know, it feels like we're in like a shrine, a relic. It's a strange place to be.
Feels special.
If Luka did not become a professional footballer, what kind of opportunities were here for children born sort of in the mid-1980s who would be my age now, let's say?
Before the war, there were factories. There were something to do if you did not deal with the raising animals or agriculture business.
That type of industry in agriculture, it doesn't exist in these areas anymore.
Not much really, because the younger generations just abandoned villages like this, moved to the cities. The ones from smaller cities moved to bigger cities.
And places like this are left to ruin.
To remind of someone big who was born here.